Hi and welcome to Magoos Corner. I'm your host Trevor Greg. We'll go through the Division 1 Reserves competition this week. And Sacred Heart, sitting on top of the ladder with 10 wins and no losses, did a treat on my lads a couple of weeks ago, and still getting the job done. Henley on 8-2 at the moment. They will be, apart from them and possibly Adelaide Uni and Ross, Trevor, I think are going to be ones that will be right at the end of it, in the thick of things. Adelaide Uni on 6-4 with Ross, Trevor and Paynham. So Paynham just dropped away a tad. Goodwood Saints on 5-5. That is something that I don't think a lot of people would have seen coming. Tea Tree Gully on 4-6. Port Districts on 3-7, Salisbury North on 2-8, and my lads still to get a win and still to field a full side each week. But we'll talk about that when we get closer to it. So the first game, we had Henley hosting Sacred Heart at Henley Memorial Oval, and as predicted, it was 16-6-102 to Henley's 5-5-35. But I didn't think Henley would go down by this much. Travis Knapp kicked three, with Francis and Newman kicking one apiece. Obst, Martin, Rex, Newman and Del Bello and Race, and getting in the best players there for Henley. Delmenico kicked four, Turton with three, Doak with three, Atkinson with the couple. Best players for Sacred Heart were Thompson, Button, Clark, Delmenico, Wooldridge and Bruckner. So a nice win for Sacred Heart at Henley. The next game, Paynham Norwood Union, hosted Port Districts, I should say, at Paynham Oval. And a good result here, 17-7-109 to Port Districts 13-5-83. Still a relatively close game, but a good result for Payne in the end. Trainos with four, Wanky with three, Santilla with two, Costanzo with a couple. Agarastis only getting the single one this week. Best players was Charlton, Wanky, Costanzo, Santillo and Costanzo for Payne. Port Districts, Bailey with a couple, Wiseman with two, Heath Pocock with a couple, with Parker, Perry, Jenkins and Clark getting one apiece. Pocock, Perry, Clark, Bailey and Wiseman getting in the best players. So still a very good calibre of players there for Port Districts, but Paynham getting the job done because they're very, very good in their twos. Tea Tree Gully hosted Goodwood Saints at Pettiringer Oval, and Goodwood Saints 9-13-67 to Tea Tree Gully 6-3-39. Now Mascotta kicked three, Doyle, Hallandale and Penny were the goal kickers for Tea Tree Gully. Hallandale, Penny, Hannah, Thompson and McWaters getting in the best players. And for Goody Saints, it was Good with three, Preston with two, George, Ewers, Kerr and Rosa getting on the score sheet. Beach, Johnson, Scott and Crook getting in the best players. So nice win there for Goodwood Saints, but still not in the position that a lot of people would think that they would be after 10 rounds of football. So moving on to the next one, we had Adelaide University hosting Ross, Trevor, and Adelaide Uni 13-5-83, defeating Ross, Trevor 4-8-32. Nice win to Adelaide Uni. They're going to be right up there when it comes to the finals time in Division 1 Reserves. Dolan with four, Deering with a couple, Green, McQueen and Peniment, and best players were Slate, Wellington, Connell, Johnson, Peniment and Dolan. And for Ross, Trevor, Tag, Garver, Daniel and Jordan. Jordan, Ash, Bowler, Wilkie, Deegan and DeBoy getting in the best players there. And the last game of the round, unfortunately, Salisbury North came down to the Dome at Port Reserve, and Salisbury North 16-19-115 to my lads 117. The goal kickers were for Salisbury North were Cox, Kutlarkis, Behrens, Colhane, McBride and Norris. I thought Cox and Kutlarkis were very, very good. Ashby was a solid three goal scorer for Portland. Simon Brooke, Steve Vanderberg, Dutram, McKay and Condelos getting in the best players. So another tough day at the Dome. We've got a lot of injury concerns at the moment, a lot of depth being tested at our club. So it's the same as clubs like Kilburn and so on, where you're rocking up to play footy because that's just what you do, and you've got to take your hat off to clubs that can still do that. But hopefully, looking towards 2016, it could be a better year, but we'll just have to see how things pan out. So at this stage, the goal scorers at this point is 35 goals to Travis Knapp from Henley, 28 to Sam Jordan from Sacred Heart. From Ross, Trevor, Adam Richter with 25, who was with Strata Agarastis, the young lad from Paynham, in fourth. And Aidan Offey, still a 19 from Adelaide Uni. Looking at this week's game, Goodwood Saints host Districts at Goodwood Oval. Districts haven't, I think it'll be too hard for them. I think the Goodwood Saints will get the job done, and it'll be, you know, a bit of an upset. I think a lot of people are thinking the Districts have got the momentum, they've got the players, but in saying that, Goodwood at home for me. Henley hosts Salisbury North. I think Henley will be reeling from last week, and I don't think they'll let it happen again. Salisbury North didn't have the players or the calibre as what they did against us in round one. So I think Henley at home will be too strong, and they'll be accustomed to the conditions a little bit more than what Salisbury North will. Paynham to Sacred Heart at Paynham Oval. Tough game. Very, very tough game. Looking at the smaller oval, I think it'll be a tough game, but I do believe Sacred Heart will get the job done. Although I'd like to see Paynham win, but Sacred Heart for me. But if Sacred Heart come out and play football like they did against us, where they were a little bit lax and things weren't hitting and they weren't sealing the deal, they weren't actually finishing off and they kicked a lot of points against us. If they play like that against Paynham, they will be in for a rude shock, and Paynham will then just run away with it. But I do believe Sacred Heart will get the job done. Tea Tree Gully host Ross Trevor at Pettiringer Oval. This one is going to be a pretty good game. We looked at Tea Tree Gully in seventh. Their A grade are doing extremely well. But for me, I do believe that Ross Trevor will get the chocolates and they'll bounce back. Adelaide Uni and Portland at University Oval. Going to be a tough game. The conditions, rainy, low teens, big oval. But the oval's actually, I think, been redone over the past 12 months, and it does drain extremely well, not like it used to through that, I think it's the north-western pocket where it just accumulates a big puddle of water. But it's going to be a tough day, and I think we will be extremely competitive and see how we go. That's it for round 10, the review, looking into round 11 for Division 1. Make sure you subscribe to the SA Footballer magazine. It's free, 180 plus pages of pure football genius, and we'll catch you again next week.